Hey everybody, we're hanging out at Cavendish Beach Music Festival with Terri Clark.
Hi Shannon.
Thanks for being here.
It's great to be here.
And nice to finally meet you.
Well, it's nice to meet you too. And I'm just glad to be here. This is my first time playing this festival and I've been around for a minute, so it's kind of weird that this is actually 23 years later, I'm finally getting to do this. So,
wow, that's cool. I've never been out here either, and it's beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
Really cool.
Yes, so, in July.
I know. I'm glad we got to come at this time of year. So we're going to play a little 10 Things to Know About You.
Okay.
First question, what's your favorite song that you've written?
No Fear.
Oh, good choice. You have a lot to choose from there.
Yeah, I do, and I tend to like, all my hits are very up-tempo and, kind of amped up, up-tempo stuff. So, the ones that I really, really resonate with and love the most, though, are songs like No Fear, and then there's a song on my Roots and Wings record that I wrote for my mom who passed away of cancer called Smile. Those types of songs that really dig deeper are the ones that I...
Absolutely.
...that mean the most to me.
Definitely. Next one. What's the nickname that friends give you?
My friends mostly call me by my last name. A lot of people in the industry call me TC.
TC?
Yeah.
Next time I see you, I'm going to call you
yes,
TC.
Yes, but my friends from high school call me Clark, Clarkster, Clarky.
You have a good last name.
Some version of my last name, right?
You have a good last name to work with.
Yeah.
All right. What was your first job?
My first job was rubbing rice.
Rubbing rice? Well,
yes. Would you like a description?
I would love to know what rubbing rice means.
So my first job, I worked at a Chinese restaurant, and they would steam these big vats of rice that came in these big like metal
bins
things.
Yeah.
And that would all stick together, like, and form this solid shape.
Like a block of rice.
Yeah. So I'd sit on a bucket that was upside down, and I would, after I washed my hands, I would pull it all apart. So I was the rice rubber.
All right. So what is your, maybe an artist, a young artist that you have been impressed by the most?
Oh, gosh.
That stood out to you?
There are a lot of them. Maren Morris, my church, I love that song. It's hard for me to, pick one.
Pick one, yeah.
Thomas Rhett, I'm kind of partial to because, I babysat him one time when he was a toddler.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Oh, my gosh.
His dad and I.
Coolest babysitter ever, by the way.
His dad and I got our publishing deals together, and he was a toddler at the time.
That is so cool.
And if I'd have known that little kid was going to grow up and I'd be opening shows and festivals for him, that would have been a weird thing to know back then, right?
Definitely. All right, what's your drink of choice?
Red wine.
Absolutely.
All day long.
No explanation needed for that one. Okay.
It's natural. It comes from the fruits.
It goes
the ground.
With all the things.
Yes, it goes with all the things, and it's organic as can be.
And I think there's a saying, a glass of red wine a day.
Yeah, a bottle of red wine a day is great for you.
A bottle of red wine
yes.
a day. That's the best. Okay. Do you remember your first show ever?
Oh, it was probably in my hometown in Medicine Hat. It was probably a talent contest. I used to enter a lot of talent shows locally.
Cool.
Just to get a vibe for what people would, say and what they would think about me. And if I had what it took to make it in Medicine Hat, then I might be able to go to Nashville at some point. But you got to kind of start at a certain level. But yeah, I was playing, some of the talent contests and stuff in bars around my hometown.
Cool. Okay. Favorite memory or milestone in your career so far? I'm sure you've got a lot.
I think becoming a Grand Ole Opry member is a big one.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And pretty cool, Kelly Prescott got to play the Opry with you and Dallas Smith.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm bringing the Canadian in. I'm bringing all the Canadians up on the Opry stage, because it's lonely being the only female Canadian member of that wonderfully magical establishment.
I got to go for my first time this year.
Did you like it?
Oh, my God.
Awesome.
I had goosebumps the whole time.
Oh.
Dinner with anybody in the world. Who would it be? Dead or alive?
Dead or alive? Patsy Cline. No question.
Yes, I would love to have been at that dinner. I feel like a lot of good conversation
and a lot of
red wine.
Four wet letter words probably too. Yeah.
Okay, if you're not listening to country, what do you turn on?
I listen to all kinds of things. A lot of jazz, like old school jazz.
Cool.
And some more contemporary jazz like Diana Krall. But I love jazz. I like trip hop, believe it or not.
Wow.
I like... a lot of singer-songwriter, acoustic-driven, like Bon Iver and stuff like that, that just chills me out. I don't like a lot of noise. I'm about the chill. Yeah.
Cool. All right. And one artist that you would love to collaborate with?
One artist that I would like to collaborate, that I would love to, it's so hard to pick just one. Like Bonnie Raitt would be awesome.
Right.
Well, if we're going to go big, we go Paul McCartney. He's the only living, one of the only living Beatles left. And I think he sings better than Ringo, so... You know, that would be, I feel like the Beatles were such trailblazers and changed the face of music forever.
Definitely. So. All right, cool. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Have fun at Cavendish.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I'll tell Kelly Prescott you said hi.
I would love that. That was 10 Things to Know About Terri Clark on Complete Country.